Okay, if Jupiter is there as a, okay, the person will have this one. If Jupiter is there, 5th lord, 2nd lord or 11th lord, out of these three houses, if Jupiter is the lord of that house and Jupiter has gone to, or if Jupiter is angular to a moon, from moon it has gone to the angular sign, right? So this is how the person will have Akhand Samraj Yoga. Akhand Samraj Yoga means the person will have wide kingdom. Acknowledgement, the people will recognize him, you know, as a wide kingdom. The person will be emperor type. Wide kingdom is Akhand Samraj. The Samraj or the kingdom of that person will be without any disturbance. Akhand, okay, not disturbed, not disturbed one, but Akhand one, okay, without any division, without any partition. So this is how the both are having. In this case, 5th lord, and you understand that this can happen only for these fixed signs only. When fixed signs are occupied by, Lagna is occupied by fixed sign, and this Akhand Samraj Yoga only can happen for this fixed sign, immovable signs. Okay, when immovable signs are in the Kendra, 1, 4, 7 and 10. Okay, for immovable signs only this Akhand Samraj Yoga can happen. In this case also, this 11th lord is Jupiter. Pisces sign is 12th sign, or Pisces sign is lorded by Jupiter. So Jupiter is the lord of 11th sign here, in this case, 11th house. 11th house is lorded by Jupiter. And Jupiter is also aspecting 10th house. Okay, first let me talk about Akhand Samraj. So this person will also be recognized, will have wide kingdom. Wide kingdom is the people will understand him, will follow him, his rule will be followed by a number of people throughout the country or throughout wide area, wide kingdom. So this is known as Akhand Samraj Yoga. Okay, because moon has gone to the angle, or moon is angular to Jupiter, Jupiter is angular to moon, they say. So if Jupiter has gone to the 11th lord, 2nd lord or 5th lord, and this can only happen for, why? For here, this is the Scorpio sign, which is fixed sign. 2nd lord is Jupiter, 5th lord is also Jupiter. In this case, 2 lords are Jupiter, 2nd lord and 5th lord. So 2nd lord, 5th lord and 11th lord. If it's Jupiter, this one thing. Okay, and then he said that, is angular to moon. Okay, and is angular to moon. So moon, from moon, it is in the angle, or from central position. So this is central position from moon. This is 4th house, 7th house. And this is 10th house. If moon was, if Jupiter was here, or in the with moon as well, okay, so that will be known as angular position. If moon is in angular position, the Akhand Samraj Yoga will be there. But in this case, 11th lord, because 12th sign is occupied by, or is lorded by Jupiter. So Jupiter has gone to, now this is, moon is angular to Jupiter. In this case, moon has gone to the Kendra, 7th house. So this is how Akhand Samraj Yoga is also formed here. The person is also well recognized. Okay, now why he was unifier, as you say, he is Iron Man. But in this case, Saturn is Yogkarak planet. Okay, 10th lord has gone to the 9th house, which is his own sign, and Mars is also there. So this person is so much, I mean, full of strength. He will be, his rule will be followed by number of people. Right, so this is how Akhand Samraj Yoga also have told you that he can make the kingdom of his Akhand without any disturbance, without any division. You can unify them. So Akhand Samraj Yoga is also showing that the person will have Akhand Samraj Yoga. Means he will make the country one, unify. Okay, so the person will unify the country. In this case, more powerful, because Jupiter in this case is, has gone to the 4th house and is lord of 5th house as well as 2nd house. 9th lord, ninth sign is lorded by Jupiter, and the 12th sign, Pisces lord, is also Jupiter. Jupiter is Sagittarius sign, this 9th sign is known as Sagittarius. This is also lorded by Jupiter. So 2nd lord, 5th lord is Jupiter, has gone to Kendra, angular position from moon. So this is very positive. Here also, Jupiter is 11th lord. This is how, and this can only happen for this one. Now, so far as this Akhand Samraj Yoga is also shown in South Indian scriptures, There is one Ved Keralam or something, Ved Keralam or South Indian book, in which it has been said that if Jupiter must be 10th lord as well, okay, if Jupiter is 10th lord, then Akhand Samrajya will form. That can also be seen that in this case Jupiter is aspecting 10th house. So that is known as immortality person will gain. So immortality yoga is also there. This combination is forming immortality. The person will be immortal. Physically nobody is immortal. Means the person is not Amar. Okay, the person will be Amar, will be recognized by the people forever in the future life also. When the person is no more, he will be recognized by the people. He will be immortal. Immortal means without, the people will recognize him even in future life. When the person is no more, even then the person will recognize him, okay, by his name. So his name is immortal. The person will be immortal. Immortality comes when 10th lord is Jupiter, or Jupiter is aspecting 10th house. Now Jupiter is aspecting 10th house in this case. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Fifth aspect is of Jupiter. Jupiter is having three aspects. Jupiter, Saturn and Mars. These are known as outer planets, as I've already described in Basics of Astrology. You can go through my Basics of Astrology, in which I have discussed that outer planets are having three aspects. While inner planets means within Sun and Earth, inner planets are Jupiter, Venus and Mercury. So these Venus and Mercury are having only one aspect, seventh aspect. Okay, seventh aspect only. Opposite house is aspected by this seventh house. Opposite houses are only aspected by inner planets. What are the inner planets? Mercury and Venus are in between Sun and Earth. And outer planets are Mars, Jupiter and Saturn. These three planets are known as outer planets, away from Earth. Earth, Sun and in between Earth and Sun, these are not planets. These planets are not there. They are known outer planets. So outer planets are Mars, Jupiter and Saturn is beyond. Saturn is, because of the Saturn is Mandgraha. Okay. Mandgraha. Mandgraha means Saturn is moving slowly. Take more time to surround the Sun. That's because of that, the Saturn is known as the Mandgraha. Okay, Dev Guru Mand Yogi. Dev Guru is Jupiter and Mand means Saturn. So Saturn is also known as the Mand planet, Mandgraha. Mand means which is moving slowly. Yes, I know science is described by our Vedic astrology with 100% surety. Now this is being practically is applicable here. Okay, now people, scientists are finding that yes, Saturn is away from all the planets, so taking more time to cover to take a round of Sun. Okay, so around the Sun, Saturn is moving, but Saturn takes more time than that of the other planets. That's why Saturn is known as Mandgraha. Okay, as let me tell you one slope which says that Dev Guru Mand Yoge Anupachya Bhavaneshu Manadhan Hino, right? Upachaya Bhavaneshu Prakhyato Rajpushta Bhakti. If Saturn, Mandgraha and Dev Guru means Jupiter, if they are conjoined together in 3rd house, 6th house, 10th house, 11th, they are Upachaya houses. And Anupachaya houses are other than these four. So if these two planets are posited other than these four houses, then the person is having no recognition. Okay? Dhanahino, or the person will have no money less, the person will be moneyless recognitionless, he will not be appreciated by the people. Okay, Dev Guru Mand Yoge Anupachya Bhavaneshu Man Dhanahino. Man means honor, he will be honorless, the person will not be honored by anybody, he will be here ill famous person will be there. Okay, so if these two planets are together, Mand Yoge, Dev Guru Mand Yoge, Dev Guru means Jupiter, Mand means Saturn. So I'm just talking about how our rishis have, recognized these planets as Mand planet, Mand Saturn. So Saturn is known as Mand. As I told you that already talked about Mars. Mars is known as Son of Earth. Okay, that verse I've already cited. I think complete, not completely. Let me started completely.
Brahma Murari Tripurantakari Bhanu Shashil Bhum Shuto Bhum Shut. Bhum Shut means Mars. Bhanu means Surya. Bhanu Shashi Shur, Chandrama means Moon. Bhanu Shashi Bhum Shuto Bhum Shut means Mars. Buddhascha or Buddha. These four planets are there. So Bhanu Shashi Bhum Shuto Buddhascha. Guru Sukraha Shani Rahu Ketava Sarve Graha Santikara Bhavanti. This, you know, prayer, this prayer is always cited by the pandits at the time of worshipping in any temple or at worshipping any puja, doing puja or something, worshipping any god or any idol. So that is at that time they always cite this slok, this verse is cited by those people. So in this includes all the three gods, I mean three incarnations of God, three forms of God, Brahma, Murari, Tripurantakari, Brahma, Vishnu and Mahesh. Okay, Brahma, Murari, Tripurantakari, Bhanu, Surya, Bhanu, Shashi, Chandrama means moon, sun, moon, Bhanu, Shashi, Bhumishuto, Bhumishut means Mangal, Mars. So Mars is there, Bhumishuto, Buddhista. So I am just talking about Bhumishut. Why Rishis were calling Mars as Bhumishut, means son of earth? Because Mars is having the similar kind of characteristics as Earth is having. Okay, Earth, Sun, as I told you that when scientists or you know rocketists went there on the Mars and they took the soil from there, tested here in the on the Earth after coming to Earth, and they found that Earth and soil of Earth and soil of Mars are similar, same. And because of that, Mars is known as Bhumishuto, Bhumishut, Prithviputra. Okay, or Dharashuto, Bhumishuto, Dharashuto, Prithviputra, etc., etc. These words are used by our rishis in Puranas, in Upanishads, in Vedas, almost all the scriptures. Astrological scriptures are always there, they are supporting all the Vedas and all these things. Okay, so this, because of that, Vedic astrology is scientifically 100% true, astronomical based, longitude, latitude, we have to calculate, only then we can find out what are the proper position of the planets there. So this is how science, Vedic astrology is 100% true science. There is no doubt about this. And because of that, people can predict with 100% surety. Now come to the point. So this is how Mand, I always talk about Mand and Dharashuta. Dharashuta means Prithviputra. But, or, Bhanu Shashi Bhumishuta. So Bhumishuta. Bhumishuta means Mars. Okay, so all the seven planets are, nine planets are, okay, are cited here. Bhanu Shashi Bhumi Shuto Buddhascha Guru Shukra Sani Rao Guru Shukra Sani Rao Ketu Sarve Graha Sani Rao and Ketu. All the planets are what you call are protecting us. Sarve Graha Shantikara Vantu, they will give us peace, they will be peaceful to us. This is how this prayer is appreciated, is cited by all the pandits at the time of puja, at the time of worshipping the or doing any yagya or yagna or anything. Okay, so worshipping time, at the worshipping time, pandits are citing this slok, this worship. So this is including all the forms of God, the three forms of Brahma, Vishnu and Mahesh, those three forms of God, and then other nine planets. Okay, so this is how citation is there. So I was just talking about Saturn and Mandu. Mandu, why it is known as Mandu? Because Saturn takes more time to revolve around the sun. Because of that, sun, Saturn is known as Mandu. Okay, and Vasudha and Prithviputra is sun, sorry, Mars. And because of that, Mars is known as Prithviputra. Now come to the point. And you will be just, you know, surprised that this is not, I mean, recognized by me at the moment, but 20 to 25 years back, there was one. One congregation was there of astrologers, and one of the astrologers, okay, a person who came, who after delivering the speech on the stage came by the gallery side, and I was sitting on the chair in the gallery when that person approached me, and the smell, you know, the smell of the sweat which was running from that body, from the body of that speaker, and I just smelled that that body of her, body of that speaker, and I asked that person that please tell me where is your Mars, where your Mars is situated in your horoscope. And that person smiled at me, that why are you asking me?
that I don't, but I told that person that you must be a Mangali. Your Mars is either in the 8th house or in the 5th house, sorry, in the 7th house or in the 4th house or in the Lagna or in the 12th house. These five places, if Mars is there, then the person will have the smell of the body of that person, of the sweat. If the sweat is running, the smell of the sweat will be just like sand, okay, the soil. The soily smell will be there in the sweat of that person. This is how I recognize that person from smell. And that person smiled at me that and told me that yes, that person's Mars is situated in the in his horoscope in the 8th house. So that person was Mangali or Mars. Okay, so this is how Mars, position of Mars in the horoscope of a person can give you the scenty smell of your sweat. And this is 100% true. I have recognized. I can recognize the person's from the smell of the person. Sweat is running, that person is smell, or smelling just like soil, sandy smell is coming from that person's sweat, that is, that person is having the more aspect of Mars in that person's horoscope, right? This is how the position of Mars is said, that person is Mangali. So this is not known to me from today or from when Rakesh went to, initially, the satellite has gone to the Mars from India or from other countries also they have gone there. But the point is that this is known to us from the childhood period because we could understand that how the person's sweat is smelling, okay? So this is how Mars position in the horoscope of a person can give the smell of that soily type smell in the sweat of a person. Now come to the point next. So this is practically 100% true because this is practical life. Yeah, Vedic astrology is useful in the life of a person. Practically, it's a practical science. There's no doubt about this. It's useful for the person. Because if the person is recognizing that, yes, I will have this kind of sufferings in my life, then he can take precautions already. He will not suffer with a sudden shock. Okay, he will not be shocked because he was knowing already that this kind of suffering will be faced by that person, will come in the future of that person. As Mr. Woodrow White says, the English writer, the English children's story writer, he says that initially I was not believing that my wife will die in this period, but that astrologer told me that your wife will die during this period, and my wife died. Initially I was laughing at that person, that how my beautiful wife can die, but she died in the same period as the astrologer told me. Then he told, and he became then optimistic. He has written his autobiography as Confessions by an Optimist. Confessions by an Optimist. Okay, so that you can go through his autobiography, how he is recognizing Vedic astrology, Indian astrology as 100% true science, he says. Okay, and he has appreciated Indian astrologers a lot. So English people are appreciating Indian astrologers. This is 100% true now because Europeans are recognizing. We come to know that when foreigners are recognizing our science, then we understand that what is the importance of our Vedic astrology. Then we people go through astrology, this and that. Do astrologers know about our future and this and that? Okay, so this has also happened with me because initially I was not knowing all these things because studying science and this and that. And when I came to know about my whole life, or when I just read all these people's comments, foreigners' comments, and I went to the astrologers, and then I come to know. Because in the beginning, I was having knowledge of all these things, but not taking so much seriously. After that, I took it seriously. Okay, so this is how the thing is. The people are saying that what is Vedic astrology? Importance of Vedic astrology is what? So I'm telling you that importance of Vedic astrology is 100% true science. There is no doubt about this. If person is having doubt, that means the person's data is not true. He is having wrong prediction. The reason is data is not correct. Okay, so all these people, the foreigners I have seen, their writings I have seen. One person from USA was saying that out of 21 questions which has said by the astrologer to me, Indian astrologer has told me, 18 questions are 100% true up to now. They have happened true. And the three questions will also happen in my future life. There is no doubt about this. He says it like this. Okay. So this is how the comments of the foreigners people, Americans people are also believing in Vedic astrology nowadays. Most of the people. Whosoever is coming in the touch of astrology, Vedic astrology, they understand the what is importance of Vedic astrology. So the people are just, you know, following this. You know, so please just, you know, I want that people who are seekers of knowledge, though, who want to study the astrology, want to know about their whole life, their children's life, their family life, their parents' life, what is their, I mean, family tradition, etc., etc., country's life. So this comparison I'm just taking because these are known people. You can understand their events, their happenings can be read from the sources available. Okay, online availability is there of their sources, their recognition, I mean their future, their life, the whole life is described the people nowadays. So okay, so from there you can get the events of their life, that how this is happening. Now next thing I was talking about, okay, so Akhand Samraj Yoga, and I've talked about Immortality Yoga. Both the people are having Immortality Yoga. Immortality Yoga is that 10th house is aspected by Jupiter. Here Jupiter is aspecting 10th house. Tell me about how 5th aspect. Well, Jupiter is the external planet, as I told you, Mars, Jupiter and Saturn. They are external planet because they are away from, not in between Earth and Sun, but away from Earth, away from Sun, okay, or from the Earth as well. So Earth from away, first is Mars, then Jupiter, and after that Saturn. So these are only external planets. These external planets are having 3 aspects. Well, 3 aspects, Jupiter is having 3 aspects, 5th aspect, 7th aspect. Jupiter is aspecting 7th house also, which is Aries sign. And Aries sign is very friendly sign, because Mars is lord of this sign. So 12th house is very good for Sardar Patel. 12th house means foreign. In foreign also he will be recognized. Foreign people will be recognized, he will be liberated as well. Liberation is there, moksha. This is 12th house, is often known as Mukti house or moksha house. In our Vedic astrology supports the Vedic, you know, things, the 4 ashramas. Okay, what is that? Brahmacharya ashram, Grihastha ashram, Sannyasa ashram, and Sannyasa ashram, Grihastha ashram, and Vanaprastha ashram. Okay, and then Dharma, Artha, Kama, Moksha. Dharma, Artha, Kama, and Moksha. Moksha is the last stage of every human being. This is how Vedic Vedas say, or Vedic scriptures say, that Moksha is the last liberation of the soul. Liberation means the soul has joined God. Because Vedic astrology or the Vedic thinking or the, you know, say Indian thinking is that people are just part of the God. Okay, or the soul is just a part of God. It is separated from God. But if the God, it will join God again, that means the person has liberated, has got moksha. So mukti is there. In this case also, the Aries sign is supported, is positive, aspected by Jupiter. Jupiter is a friend of this house. So this Jupiter, this is also, I mean, very good house. 12th house is very good. He will be recognized in foreign countries. Foreigners will believe in him. Whatever the person, you know, having birth at a place, from away from his birthplace, the person will be recognized. This is what the foreign house. This 12th house is known as foreign house, or moksha house as well, mukti house, liberation house. This house, 12th house, is powerful. And in this case also, Saturn is aspecting this one. Third aspect, Saturn's are three aspects, 10th aspect, 7th aspect, and 3rd aspect. These were the three. 1, 2, 3, 7th sign, in 7th sign, Saturn is exalted. So exaltation sign is there. So this 12th house is also exalted in this case. He will also be recognized in foreign countries. Foreigners will recognize him. He is also having liberation, moksha, mukti. Okay, so his soul will also join God. This is how moksha is also there. So mukti or moksha, this is in both these natives are having mukti, moksha. Okay, so this is how liberation of their soul. This is how our Vedic scriptures say that person will have liberation. This 12th house is very positive. Exaltation sign is there, or is exalted. 12th house is exalted, is having positive aspect here. Even, you know, Mercury is aspecting, Venus is aspecting. Venus and Mars neutral. Okay, Mars and Venus are neutral. So 12th house is also aspected by Venus. This is also positive because neutral planet is there. Mercury is also aspecting. Mercury is inimical but retrograde. So Mercury is not so much affected, because Mercury always behaves as the planets behave. Okay, whatever planet is combined by, joined by Mercury. Mercury acts according to that planet. So Mercury is also aspecting 12th house. Here liberation is also there. So Mukti house. So 12th house is very powerful of both the natives. Okay, so this is how. Immortality, as I have told you about, that one astrologer, good astrologer has said that immortality, fragrance of immortality is there in a native horoscope. The 10th house is aspected by Jupiter. Here also Jupiter is aspecting 10th house. 7th aspect. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The 7th aspect, Jupiter is aspecting 10th house of Mr. Modi also, because this is Leo sign. Leo sign is friendly sign again of Jupiter. So Jupiter is aspecting 10th house of Mr. Modi also. So he is also having immortality, fragrance of immortality. That Shugan, the scent of immortality is also present in Mr. Modi's house. He will be immortal afterwards. Okay, the person will be recognized in his future also. I mean, after he is no more, and after that people will recognize him. When the body, because people will have to die. After our death, our physical existence is gone. But if the person is recognized afterwards, that's known as immortality. Okay, person will be immortal because of his name, because of his character, because of his attitude, because of his activities, because of whatever karmas he has done. Those karmas will be recognized by the person in future life also. The person will be, both these people are immortal, because immortality is there. 10th house is aspected by Jupiter, or 10th lord is Jupiter. Now South Indian scripture, that as I told you, that known as Veda Keralam or Veda Keralam, that says the 10th house is lorded by Jupiter. If, or Jupiter is the lord of 10th house, Jupiter is 10th lord, then Akhand Samraj Yoga will be there. That I have already talked about. But immortality comes when 10th house is aspected by Jupiter. This is 100% true. And 10th house is lorded by Jupiter, or 10th house is position in the 10th house, I mean 10th house is posited by Jupiter, or Jupiter is aspecting 10th house. This is aspecting 5th aspect, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The 5th drishti of Jupiter is on the 10th house of Sardarji, and because of that he will be immortal. The person's name will be known to the people, to the future generations as well. Okay, the future generation will recognize this person forever. So this is also here, because here Jupiter is aspecting 10th aspect is there. Okay, so 10th aspect, due to 10th aspect, Jupiter is aspecting, okay, this 10th house also. This is how immortality is there. Now next thing, next yoga let me talk about. There are two or three more yogas. Okay, so immortality I have talked about, Akhand Samraj Yoga, Anuf Yoga I have talked about. Okay, then there are, you know, Matrishni Yoga. Matrishni Yoga he is having. Mother will have affection towards the person. Okay? Even if the 10th house is aspected by, not aspected, but 10th house is loaded by Sun, which is debilitated, but debilitation sign is crossed. Debilitation degree is crossed. Because here, Sun is of 15 degree. Sun is at 15 degrees. Sun is debited at 10 degrees. So 10 degrees is crossed by Jupiter, by Sun. But Sun is with Jupiter. Sun is conjoined by Jupiter, by Mercury, okay, by Jupiter as well, for Venus as well. So Sun is here in conjunction with positive benefit planets. So with benefit planets, a fourth lord is there. That means the fourth house is also positive. Fourth house is represented by mother. His mother's house is the fourth, is traveling, is position house. His position undoubtedly has diminished, because initially he was becoming Prime Minister of India, but he was not recognized region boss. He was, you know, what do you call, silenced by Mahatma Gandhiji and others. Okay, asked him to resign from that presidency, and they said that, and he didn't become the Prime Minister, but he became the Deputy Prime Minister. Even then he was having power. Then he came to know that people are against him. Mahatma Gandhi is against him because he was not allowed to become Prime Minister. Even if he was having, out of 13 points, he was having 12, people were supporting him. 12 Congress members were supporting him. Out of 13, only one was with Pandit Nehru. This is how Even then he resigned from the prime ministership. So they said he was knowing then since then. Yes, and so I was just talking about that how these positions are there. Now after that, after all these discussions, as I told you, that he is having, there is no problem to children. Children he will have, elderly brothers he will have, younger brothers, sisters will be lesser in number but will be there. Okay, the person is having all prosperity. But this in the fourth house, sorry, the seventh house is moon. From moon, sun is there in the 12th house, as well as the lord of 8th house has gone to, is exalted undoubtedly. Okay, will be recognized by his marriage also. Marriage partner will be from well to family, but even then is conjoined with Saturn. So the person, the wife's life will be, or the spouse will be of lesser life, means the life will be diminished. The reason is the wife will have less life, I mean will die earlier. Okay, and even then, because he was characterful, the person was having morality, so he didn't marry second time, as he was having children already. As people say that he was having, he must have the children, he was having children. After that he just took care of the children with the help of his family members, but he didn't marry after the spouse died because of cancer or something. Okay, he was operated upon and it is being said. Okay, so I've just come to know about that he was having a spouse but died earlier. The reason is 7th house lord there, and 7th house is also being occupied by devoted planet. Moon has gone to Scorpio sign, and Scorpio sign, in Scorpio, undoubtedly Moon is not devoted in this case because cross the life, so Bible will be there. Okay, Moon is occupying the 7th house, which is devoted sign of Scorpio sign is devoted sign for Moon, but Moon has crossed the devoted sign, devoted degree. Because of that, moon, wife will be there, 7th house, to present the spouse. For husband, it is wife's house. For a wife, it is a husband's house. 7th house is occupied by moon, which is debilitation, in the debilitation sign, but has crossed debilitation sign, which is not completely debilitated. The reason is he will be married, will have married partner or marriage partner. His spouse will be there, but will die early. This is all how this debilitation moon is has crossed the debilitation sign. So this is known as Nichabhanga Raja Yoga. Nichabhanga Raja Yoga is the planet has crossed its degree. So Nichabhanga is there, means debilitation is cancelled. But even then, debilitation will be there. The reason is, as one of the astrologers has said to me, that the position of this kind of planet, if the moon has any planet has crossed its devolution sign, devolution degree. If degree is crossed by the, or devolution is Nichabhanga, means has been cancelled. Okay, or this is known as Nichabhanga Raja Yoga. That Raja Yoga says that the person will have that kind of activity, but even then he will be, that person will cross over that. You cannot say that person will not have his spouse. He will have spouse. But the spouse will die earlier, as he said that if a person supposes has gone into a well, okay, agar kuwa mein koi girta hai, but kuwa is andhkoop, usme se nikalte aata, he has got the golden coins. Okay, so the person will have recognition. What is recognition? He was a determined person, he didn't marry second time, so he was recognized as a morally very sound person, he didn't marry second time. Even if he was forced with his family, by his family members, parents, but he didn't marry second time due to the children will suffer in the hands of second wife. So because of that, he didn't marry second time. So morally, he was very, very much sound person. Okay, so sound of conduct, sound of morality. The person has morality in this case. Okay, so this Mars is exalted here. Even if seventh lord is exalted, the person will have the spouse from a very well recognized family than that of his own. This is how the families of the the wife will be there. Family of wife will be of the higher category. I mean, the person's family may be a poor family initially, was farmer family or this farmer's family or this and that. But because other than spouse, family will be of higher status. This is how Jupiter 7th house has exalted, has gone to exaltation sign,
or has been exalted in the ninth house, luckily. So that is due to his luck, he got married. Earlier, I think he got married at 16 years or something. But it must be, this is what, I do not know what the position of his spouse or his wife's family. But wife's family will be of higher status than that of his own. This is how this horoscope says. Okay, so this is the second, condition of his family. So his wife died earlier, but even then he is having children, so because of that, children suffering, he didn't marry second time, so morally very upright person, very good of conduct. Okay, so he was having elderly brothers, younger brothers also, he was having sister or brothers, I don't know, but he must have the younger sister or brother, because this second house, yeah, aspected by Mars, which is gravitation sign, but even then Moon is lord of this third house, which is of younger siblings. And Moon has crossed its devastation sign, is not completely dead. If it was devastated, then there was no position of any younger siblings. But in this case, siblings must be there, but lesser in number than that of elderly siblings. Okay, so all these things are recognized. I've discussed about Rajyogas are men. There are a number of other, as I told you, that Sadar Pradesh's house is having, our horoscope is having 70 yogas formed, different yogas. What are the yogas in this case? Let me talk about some Rajyogas. There are 7 or 8 Rajyogas formed. Okay. Rajyogas means good position. Position of means if 9th Lord, 10th Lord, they are, so this is having one Rajyoga. Again, 5th Lord, this 5th Lord is going to be benefit planets, number of planets are there. 5th Lord, I mean 6th Lord, this 5th Lord is Mercury. So it's going to Mercury and Sun, they are forming Rajyoga. Okay, because 5th Lord and, 4th Lord and 5th Lord. 4th Lord and 5th Lord, Sun and this Buddha Aditya Yoga, so this is also there. Now, the combination of this, these 4 planets, are number of yogas are formed. What is that yoga? First is, let me take two planets, Mercury, Sun, Buddha Aditya Yoga is there. Then Mercury, Jupiter, Mercury, Venus, three yogas are formed. Because of that, what will be there, what is there, so I can discuss about this for the whole, day. For the whole day I can discuss about these yogas. And then Mercury, Sun, okay. Mercury, Jupiter, Mercury, Venus, 3 yogas. Then again Sun, Jupiter, Sun, Venus, 2 more yogas, 5 yogas. Then 3 planets, let me take. 3 planets. Mercury, Sun, Jupiter, 3. This is one more yoga. Then Mercury, Jupiter and Venus, 3. 3 planets together. Then another yoga. Then Sun, Jupiter, Mercury, 3 planets, so these 4 yogas are also there. So, number of other yogas are formed because of 2 planets, 3 planets in this way. And from Moon, how many planets are in the 12th house that I've already talked about, those Anfa yogas. So, Anfa yogas, 3 or 4 Anfa yogas were there. Okay, so this is how these yogas are formed. So, these yogas are, 4 in this case, 4 and 4, 8. So, 12 yogas are formed because of this position of these planets from the Moon. Okay, so this is how this Moon's position, position of these planets from the Moon is there. They are forming. And then Rahu Ketu, in between Rahu Ketu, the planets are formed. The struggle is there in the life of the person. But because Rahu Ketu, this is not Kalsarpa Yoga, but in this case Kalsarpa Yoga is not so effective. Reason is, Rahu is in Pisces sign, which is Jupiter sign. And Ketu is in Scorpio, in this Virgo sign, which is all Mercury signs. If Mercury and Jupiter signs, if this Kalsarpa Yoga is formed, people say Kalsarpa Yoga because all the planets are between Rahu and Ketu. This is known as Kalsarpa Yoga. So person will have a lot of struggle in his life. But even then the person will be recognized. This is how recognition is there. So person had a lot of struggle in his life due to his enemy, due to his sufferings from his childhood period. And second point, let me tell you what. That when person is born in Anuradha Nakshatra, this Anuradha Nakshatra, both are born. So person will have to stay away from his birthplace. The person is staying from his birthplace, has to stay away from his birthplace. This is 100% true. Whatever his birthplace, he was born at Nadiad or somewhere. Nadiad was initially in the region of Bombay, because in British area or British time. In the British time, it was in Bombay area, but now it is in Gujarat. So he was born at Nadiad, but stayed at Ahmedabad for some time. Then he came to Delhi, so he stayed in Delhi.
So the person has to, so he stayed at Ahmedabad mostly for his barrister time when he was advocate at advocate or lawyer at the Ahmedabad court. So in those period also he stayed in Ahmedabad, means away from Nadia. So the person has to stay away from his birthplace. This is under person two. Almost all the Anuradha Nakshatra people, born Anuradha Nakshatra people, they have to stay away from their birthplace. Wherever his birthplace is there, the person has to stay away or will stay away from his birthplace. This is under question 2. I have found number of people, almost all the people whosoever has come to my life, because one of my family members, he was also, had a lot of suffering, one of my relations. Okay, he suffered a lot in his childhood period. When he was going to study to his 8th standard or 6th standard, 7th standard, he was not having even shoes in his feet. He was suffering so much. So he suffered a lot, but he was stood first in the class always throughout his life. And he became then a very good professional. Okay, and he had a lot of property afterwards. So a lot of prosperity he got after that. So person will prosper afterwards born in Anuradha Nakshatra. So Anuradha Nakshatra born person is initially has to suffer. Okay, if the planet is, because it is 3 degree, 20 degree onwards, and moon is directed 3 degree. So just nearby 3 degree if the person is born, and that one of my relations was born at 3 degree, exactly 3 degree. Okay, so 3 degree nearby 3 degree. So the moon was directed. Just Anuradha Nakshatra has started. It was in the first quarter. He was born in the first quarter of Anuradha Nakshatra. The person suffered a lot in his childhood period. And he stayed away from his birthplace. From his birthplace, he stayed elsewhere. There he made a lot of property and this and that. A lot of houses he purchased. And so that is another history. So whosoever the person is born in Anuradha Nakshatra, the Anuradha Nakshatra is Devgana. So I have already talked about basis of this. What is the Devgana, Manushyagana, Rakshasagana? Nakshatras are divided, these 27 nakshatras. They are divided into three categories, 9, 9, 9. Devgana, Manushyagana, Rakshasagana. So the nakshatra, the moon is born in moon is posited in a particular nakshatra, for example, or constellation. If that nakshatra falls in which category? Is it a Devgana, is it a Rakshasagana, or a Manushyagana? Now, in this case, Anuradha Nakshatra is a Devgana. So, both the people are Devgana type. Devgana people are, they are very respectful, very, very much learned person. They are learning a lot. They are always studying. Okay, after the knowledge, they are always intelligent person. Okay, they read the scriptures. They are classical people. They always know, they are traditional people. They can't forget their traditions. They are always classical people, and they always read the scriptures, they are follow their gurus, they respect their gurus, respect their elderly people, always learn from elderly people, or whosoever is teaching them or can get knowledge from anybody, even from enemies. So the people are learned people. So Devgana people are, or the nakshatras which are in Devgana, those people born in Devgana, they are learned persons. They respect the teacher, their gurus. Okay, so respectful to other elderly person. They always have good things from their enemies even. Okay, so enemies are being respected by him. Or they are friendly to anybody. Very good to friendship. Okay, people will have friendship with them, and their friendship is very fruitful. But they understand that what is classical, what is this and that. Okay, so both these personalities are very fastidious, determined person, very fixed upon their promises. They promised to be kept, or he was unifier of the country. Modi is also unifying the country. Now, afterwards, after this, all this discussion I have done, okay, about Sardar Patel ji and Modi ji, and after this, I will just compare their horoscopes, okay, in Koot Milan. What are the Koot Milan? Those Asht Koot Milan, there are 8 gunas. And total of those 1 to 8, if you add, that will be 36. So out of these 36 virtues, how many virtues they are having? They are together sphering. Because they are born in the same nakshatra, but different quarters. So the nadi dosh, even if they are 8, out of 8 points, there is 0 point. But even then, that is not applicable here, because they are born in different quarters. Mr. Modi is born in second quarter, and Sardar Patel is born in third quarter. they are not born in the same quarter of the same nachatra. If the people, two natives are born in the same nachatra, in the same quarter, then there is Nadi Dosha. The Nadi Dosha is there because they are born in the same nachatra, but they are in different quarters. This can be avoided. Okay, so Nadi Dosha can be, is not so much, I mean, dangerous. Dangerous means in case of partnership, these people can like their features, their physical features. So physiology factors will be accepted by each other. They will like each other. This one, because Sadarji is not there, but Mr. Modi will like his features, what kind of statue he has constructed of his. So he has liked his features, so this Nadi Dosha is not there. Even if Nadi Dosha is there, out of 8.0 points are there, so both are having Astikut Milan. Similar nachatra, if the person is born, mostly all the things are just comparable because they are having 28 gunas, virtues. They are having Astikut Milan, and out of those 36 points, they are matching with 28 points. I will discuss about these points, that what are the comparing of these two people in case of Astikut Milan. If, as I have told you about, that if you go through my third lecture series 3, please go through that lecture series 3. There I have discussed about how to match two persons, two partners, two girl and boy, or any two person. Any two persons can be compared. Their comparison of horoscopes can be done on the 8 points. There are Astikut Milan. There are 8 points. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And this total sum is 36. Out of 36, how many obtained points are there? If the first two persons are matching with maximum points out of, above than 20, and they are matching 28, out of 8, 0 point is there because Nadi Dosha is there because they are born in the same nachatra. But if I take that they are born in the different quarters of the same nachatra, so this, Nadi Dosha is just abolished, not considered bad, okay? They will like each other's features, complexion or feature. So he's liking, his feature. Sardar Patel's features are liked by him, or features are liked by him, and he has constructed his statue. This is how the features of his, the physical features, or the physique of the person is liked by another person. So this is how the physical features are, even if Nadi Dosha is there, but they are born in the same nachatra and they are in different quarters. Because of different quarters, this Nadi Dosha is not so much considered and so much, affected, so much affecting the person's liking. So Mr. Modi is liking his features, his physical features. He constructed his statue at his birthplace in Gujarat. I'm not knowing because I have not visited there. So not going to point. So this is how the physical features, except physical features, Nadi Dosha is there, which out of that 8.0 point we have taken, but even then those 8 points are not, out of 8 you can say 8 points are accepted. So 36 points are 36 points. Both are obtained out of 36 points. They are matching in Astikut Milan. 1 point out of 1, 1, out of 2, 2, out of 3, 3, because they are born in the same nachatra. So everything, they are born in, Burn is Brahmin Burn. Why Brahmin Burn? Because the moon is lying in the 8th sign. What are the Varnas? Let me just talk about how Varnas are calculated. Now let me remove these. Okay, so he died. Now, second point here. That is one thing which I just mentioned. That Sardar Patelji died on 15th December 1950. On that particular day, you understand what is the Dasha period, the time period was running of Rahu's Mahadasha, Rahu again. Antardasa, Pratindasa of Jupiter, and this Pranadasa of Rahu, Pranadasa of Mars, and Sushumdasa of Rahu. Okay, Mars is in the end. In the Mars period, he died. In the end period was of Mars. You can just understand, if you calculate this with this time period, you will find that time period, Mahadasa period was Rahu Mahadasa, Antardasa, Pratindasa, Sushumdasa, and Pranadasa. So Mars Dasa was in the end. So Mars is 7th lord, and 7th lord is known as Marak planet, Marak house. 2nd lord and 7th lord, or 7th house lord and 2nd house lord, these planets are known as Marak planet for the planet of the person. If they are very dangerous, if the period of that planets comes in the life of a person, the person must be
very cautious about.
He will suffer, or he has to suffer. Seventh house lord here is Mars, because eighth sign is there. The
yes, friends. Now I'm taking the Ashtakoot Milan of these two leaders. What is Ashtakoot Milan? Which I have discussed in lecture number 3, I think lecture series 3, in which I have talked about how to match horoscopes of two people. Either they are two couple means one a boy and the girl. They are going to marry and they are going to run the house, okay, their household things and everything. So that is means they are to be matched together, okay. And in case of two persons are going to run a business, for example, start a corporation house, okay, or two people who are leaders, they are going to run the country, then how they are matching together. So that's why I have taken these two leaders horoscope for Ashtakoot Milan. This is done, as I have already clarified in lecture series 3, that it can be done only for any two people. Any two people means two brothers can be checked, because they are fighting with each other. Then what are their, how their horoscopes are matching. So horoscopes of those two people are matching or not matching, and what is the difference between them. That is why these Ashtakoot Milan I have found very effective to understand the nature of the people, the two people who are fighting with each other. For example, the time of debates at the press conference, etc. Okay, at the media, these days television media, people are fighting with each other, and you can just understand, note down their time of birth, date of birth, place of birth, and match their horoscopes, and you will find a totally different people. They are of different ganas, different moon is positioned in different signs, which are enmical to each other. So rasis are enmical where moon is posited. So this is how we can compare the two people's horoscopes. This is 100% true, I have found, and is very applicable to those people who are understanding, who want to understand Vedic astrology, right? So Vedic astrology is just going to make the matching of the two people in a very exact manner, correct manner, exactly manner. So this is how this is why I have taken these two leaders matching on the basis of Ashtakoot Milan. Ashtakoot means eight kind of qualities, eight kind of virtues on which the two people can be matched. What are those eight qualities? I have clarified these already a number of times, but now I'm again taking. I'll take these eight qualities briefly. What are those eight qualities? Number one is, if we write from 1 to 8 serial wise and add them, 1 to 8, if we add 8 into 9 upon 2, this is sum of natural numbers from 1 to n. So that means n into n plus 1 upon 2 formula is. Okay, similarly, 8 into 9 upon 2. 2 4 ja 8, 9 4 ja 36. So total sum is 36. Sum of these 1 to 8 numbers, sum is total 36. We have to add these numbers, 1 to 8, 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 8, up to 8. So this sum will be 36. Sum of natural numbers from 1 to n. Formula is n into n plus 1 upon 2. So n here means 8. 8 plus 8 into 9 upon 2. 2 4 is 8, 9 4 is 36. So 36 is the sum. Now out of 36, how many points are matching of the two horoscopes, of the two natives? Two natives whose horoscopes are given here, are taken here, the two leaders. This is the last point of discussion here, because after that I'll take their matching. How they are matching with the horoscope of independent India. At the time of independence, India's horoscope at 12:15 at night, okay, 12:15, 12:20 or 00:15 minutes, okay, or 00:20 minutes. So at night time, India's independence time, okay, on 15th August 1947, India's independence horoscope was formed, okay, by Ujjain Panditji, or Panditji from Ujjain, okay, and that I already discussed about a lot, because at the time of COVID time, I predicted a number of things on the basis of India's independence horoscope. That horoscope I will match with these two leaders separately. Whether the independence India's horoscope is matching, or how many points are matching with these two leaders, and where they are disagreed, whether this is last point, physiological feature means physical features, the body of the country
or the physique of the country. Means in this case, physique means body of the people, native. But in case if I take country, then country is geographical region. So these two people are agreed with the geographical region of the country or not? That I'll discuss about in detail. And you will be surprised at how the two people are similar in that case. They are agreed or not agreed with the Indian geography after independence of India, that you will understand that how they are matching together. Now come to the point. So I'm taking these 8 points. Now these 8 points, let me take. First point is known as the Varna Kut. Whether they are born in the same Varna. Varna, I discussed about there are four Varnas, as you know about. And you will be surprised that this Varna system has come from astrology, Vedic astrology. And initially, the rishis were dividing the people on the basis of their birth, time of birth exactly, in which, horoscope they were born, on the basis of their birth, in which sign they are born, moon is in its position in which sign of the horoscope. On the basis of that sign, the people were judged, or the children were judged, that in which Varna they are born. Okay, so I'll just write here that what is Varna system, how do we note down Varna system. So Varna is decided, there are four Varnas, Brahman Varna, Kshatriya Varna, Vaishya Varna, Shudra Varna. How these four Varnas, nowadays after English people came here, they started dividing the country into these four castes and this and this. And so rigidly they were followed afterwards, that now people are having they are separate groups, they are forming their separate Brahman group, Kshatriya group, Vaishya group, and Shudra, because of the division policy of the British people, okay? The British, so the attackers on India, okay? So who the attackers who plundered the country, and they tried to divide the country into different groups so that they can be supported by some particular groups. So this is the politics of, what you call democracy nowadays. People are still counting caste-wise, how many caste people are supporting us, how many people of this caste will support us. This kind of things are still dividing the country into different groups. So that is given by the attackers, the British mostly. So this Varna system initially was not on the caste system. The person born in a particular family will be of the same caste or same Varna. So this Varna system was decided initially, was discussed about the astrologers basically, the Rishis, Maharshi, Ved Vyas, etc. Shur, Pitamha, Vyaso, Vasishto, Atri, Parashara, all those 18 Rishis which I have already talked about, that they are the propagators of astrology. So those propagators, those starters of astrology, those people have given this concept of Varna system. So this Varna system will decide that the two natives who are born, either they are born in the same Varna people, if they are starting a business or corporation house or running the country, they will like each other. Okay, that is what. So Varna system is decided on the basis of Rasi in which moon is positioned. For example, the moon of these two leaders is positioned in 8th sign, Scorpio sign. That horoscope you have already seen. So please see my previous video of this series. So in there I have casted the horoscope of these two people. So in that horoscope you can see that in the 8th sign moon is positioned. So moon is in Scorpio sign, 8th sign. When moon is in 4th sign, 8th sign and 12th sign, the people born are in Brahman Varna. So there are four Varnas. First is, let me take Brahman Varna, Brahmin Varna, or Brahman Varna, or Brahmin Varna, whatever you talk about. Brahman Varna, then Kshatriya Varna, Kshatriya Varna, Kshatriya Varna, and then Vaishya Varna, Traders family, Vaishya Varna, and then Shudra Varna. Shudra Varna. Okay, Shudra or SHOODRA, Shudra Varna. So this is Shudra Varna. How they are formed? If I divide the 12 signs, 12 rasis or 12 signs into four categories, three. Okay, if I take, let me take one, from Shudra. Then two, three and a four. One, two, three. If I take Shudravarna first, this is one Rasi. Okay, so one, two, three. Now let me take, or let me write that. Varna, I will write later. First, let me write the sign here. That will be better. Let me write the sign for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and this is 12. So last, this one is Brahmana Varna. Person is born is fourth sign, I mean moon is positioned in Cancer sign, fourth sign, Karkara Cancer sign, and Scorpio sign, eighth sign, and 12th Pisces sign. So this is known as Brahman Varna. Last is Brahman Varna. Right? Brahman Varna. Then this 159 is Kshatriya Varna. This is Kshatriya Varna. Kshatriya Varna. And this is Vaishya Varna 2610. Vaishya Varna. Right? Vaishya Varna. And 3, 7 and 11. If moon is positioned with third sign, Gemini sign, Libra sign and Aquarius sign, then person is born in Shudra Varna. So this is how the basic beginning of the astrology, I mean in the beginning, people were divided on the basis of their birth. Okay, in which sign they are born, moon is in which sign. Because we always write the Janma Rasi or birth sign is known as moon's position in which sign is there. That on the basis of the Janma Rasi, moon, where moon is positioned, in which sign moon is positioned, the person's Varna is decided about. So astrologically this is a process here. This is Kshatriya Varna, 159, 2610, this is Vaishya Varna, trading family, traders family, Vaishya Varna. Kshatriya Varna is who are the fighters family or the protectors, warriors family, you may say warriors family, the people who are protecting the country, warriors family. So those people who are in the army nowadays, army still the people are decided about, even the government posts are decided on the basis of first grade people, second grade people, third grade people, fourth grade people. So still the government has divided into caste system of this grading system. Those grading systems are given by the Britishers, and still the country is being decided on the basis of grades. First grade person, he is first grade official, second grade official, third, fourth category people. Okay, so in this way, this Varna system was initially just on the basis of birth sign in which moon is positioned. Even in a single family, four kind of people are living. Father is of Shudra Varna, suppose, and son is born of Brahmana Varna, daughter is born of Kshatriya Varna, and another son is born of Vaishya Varna. So all kinds of Varnas can be found in single family. Still, on the basis of astrology, you can find that most of the brothers and sisters, all of kinds are there. I mean, all Varnas are there in the same family. So this is how this was the initial decision. So if the people are of the same Varna, then one point out of one point is given. So in this case, these two people are of the same, these two leaders are of the same Varna, Brahmana Varna. So they are born in the Brahmana Varna because their moon is in the Scorpio sign, eighth sign. So Cancer sign, Scorpio sign, Pisces sign, if moon is positioned, then Varna is Brahmana Varna. So they are born in the Brahmana Varna, so one point is given. What is the development signification of this? Signification is this, that if these two kind of people are living together, suppose in the rented house, they are starting a business, corporation house, running a country, their spiritual development is there because they will not fight with each other. Any kind of same people, same Kshatriya, they are Ami Kshatriya people of there, they are of the same Varna, Kshatriya Varna, Vaishya Varna, because in that case, they will not fight with each other. They will think about their spirituality. The spiritualism, spiritual development will be there. The reason, when people are not thinking about other things, when they are fighting with each other, they are not agreed. Disagreement is there always. They are always thinking about, they are fighting the nature, this and this. They are fighting together daily, regularly. even you know, husband and wife are fighting with each other. So they are not thinking about spiritual things. Spiritual things people think about when they are peaceful, when their mind is quiet, okay, silent. They are just, you know, having peace in their mind. Then they think about God, peace, spiritualism and everything. Then they think about, okay, all other things other than these things. Otherwise, in case of fighting, they are fighting with each other. That means the people are not having time to think about God, spiritualism and this. So if they are of the same Brahma, one out of one point is there, then they will get spiritual development. Significance will be there, then the people will think about spirituality. They will think about other things. We are born from where? What is God? What is this and that? They will search for other, you know, worldly things or other things. Okay, so this is what Varna system has given signification. Now, second point is Vashikut. Vashikut here is Vash and Vaksh. Means moon is positioned in pitch sign. Okay, and pitch, that sign is of pitch quality. Pitch, I mean, there are Vash. Vash here means Vash and Vaksh. There are certain signs which are under control, or this within control. Vash means under control, and the Vaksh means which can eat, or they can be eaten. That is Vaksh. So which signs are Vakshable, or I mean eatable, can be eaten, or which are under control, within control. So the two people whose moon signs are there, and their moon signs are divided into five categories mostly. Those five categories are, let me talk about human signs. There are human signs. For example, Aries sign, Taurus sign, Aries sign, Taurus sign, these are of human nature, human category. So if a person's moon is positioned in Aries sign and Taurus sign are Chatuspada, I'm sorry. So Virgo sign and Virgo sign and Gemini sign, Virgo sign, Gemini sign, Libra sign, they are of human nature or Manav category. Okay, Manav Vashya, or they may say they are Manav category or human signs. They are known as human signs. Which one? Gemini, third sign, sixth sign, and seventh sign, and 0 to 15 degree of Sagittarius sign. They are put into human signs. They are human nature type, or these signs are of human nature. Okay, they are humanly, or they are now whether they are contributed. Suppose the persons are born in these two signs, they are of the same nature. So 2 points out of 2 points are given. So natural adjustment will be there. So they will be naturally adjustable people. Okay, they are adaptable to each other. Their adjustment will be naturally born. So the two people, two natives, if they are born in the same Vashya, same Vashya, human nature or Vanchar, they are Chatuspada, Vanchar category, sorry, Vanchar Rasi is Singh Rasi or Leo sign. Leo sign and Scorpio sign, these two signs are not given separate, they are not put into different groups or any group, they are singularly taken. Scorpio sign is Keet Rasi or Keet Vashya, and Leo sign, fifth sign is Singh Rasi or Singh Vashya, you may say, or Singh. So this under the Singh, all are eatables, because Singh means Banchar. The Singh can eat and all other things. So only Singh Rasi sign, or if a Leo sign, person is born in a Leo sign, I mean moon is in Leo sign of a person, then this person can be adjustable, naturally adjustable with another person of the same sign. If another person, the second partner, is also born in the same sign, I mean his moon or her moon is also in the same sign, the two partners, if they are born in the same sign, I mean their moon is in the Leo sign, Singh Rasi, then the people are naturally adjustable. So this natural adjustment will come. Otherwise, if you put the Singh sign or this Banchar Rasi or this Banchar Vashya, fifth sign, then other, if they are matched with other category, the moon is in another signs, Aries sign, other sign, Chatuspada. Aries sign is Chatuspada. Aries means maize, ram, meda. Okay, or he fish. So yeah, sorry, he sheep. So he sheep is ram. So ram is Chatuspada, having four-footed animal, or is four-footed animal. So ram, Taurus sign. These are you know, four-footed animal. This means Chatuspada. They are put in Chatuspada category. Jalchar category. Jalchar, Meen Rasi, 12th sign. Cancer sign also. 12th fourth sign is also in the Meena Rasi. Capricorn 15 degree to 30 degree of Capricorn is in Jalchar sign. Okay, sorry, 0 degree to 15 degree of Capricorn is in Jalchar sign. So Jalchar Rasi. So Jalchar signs. So Moon is in Jalchar sign or Jalchar Rasi. So these Jalchar Rasis or the people who are born in Jalchar sign, Meena Rasi, Leo sign, sorry, Pisces sign, 12th sign. And Cancer sign, fourth sign, they are put into Jalchar Rasi. Cancer sign, Jalchar Rasi, right? Capricorn is also put into Jalchar sign. Capricorn, half of Capricorn, 0 degree to 15 degree, that is put into Jalchar sign. So Jalchar Rasi is, or the moon is lying in the Jalchar sign, or this, Capricorn, Cancer sign, or Pisces sign, 12th sign. Then this sign, moon of this sign, is eatable. To humans as well, human category people can also eat them. Jalchar, I mean fish can be eaten by anybody, I mean humans can eat nowadays. Okay, so some people are eating fish, so they are fish eaters. So fish means Pisces, Meena Rasi. That if moon is put into Meena Rasi and that person is conjoined with, is corporating with another person whose moon is in Leo sign, will not be adjustable. Okay, off is in Keet Rasi, Scorpio sign, will not be adjustable. Okay, so because this Jalchar signs are mostly eatable to other people. They are Vaksha, that this is known as Vaksha sign or Vaksha Rasis. Vaksha Rasis to other, Vashto, within control, or it is Vaksha. Vash means within control and Vaksha means eatable. So which sign is eatable to another sign? So in, according to that, this sign, two points are allotted. Vashyakuti is decided on the basis. But these two people, these two natives, these two leaders are born in the Scorpio sign. Their moon is in the Scorpio sign. So if moon is in the Scorpio sign, that is known as Keet Vashya. Keet is just, if they are matched together, Keet with Keet, then they are given 2 points. So here 2 points are given. Because Sardar Patel is born in the same Scorpio sign, moon is in the Scorpio sign. Mr. Modi is also born in the same Scorpio sign, moon is in the Scorpio sign. Okay, in the Lagna Scorpio sign, and Sardar Patel is Scorpio sign is in the seventh house, and moon is positioned there. So moon is in the Scorpio sign of both. Nakshatriya and Rahu undoubtedly different quarters, but the moon is in the Scorpio sign, and Scorpio Vrishchik Rasi is known as Keet Rasi or Keet sign. So they are of the same category. So because of that, these 2 points are given. 2 points are allotted to them. Okay, so this is what, how we decide about this Vashya, within control. So these are divided into human signs, or Chatuspada, Jalchara, Vanchara. Vanchara means Leo sign is put into Vanchara Rasi, or Vanchara Vashya. Keet is Scorpio. So Leo sign and 8th sign, Scorpio and Leo sign, these two are separately, they are singularly put into two categories. Vanchara is Leo sign and Keet Rasi is Scorpio sign. And others are put into groups. Jalchar, humans as I told you, Leo, Virgo sign, Gemini sign, Virgo sign, Leo and Libra sign, three. And 15 degree, 0 to 15 degree of Sagittarius. These four are put into human categories. Sorry, this humans. These are humans. And Chatuspada, four-feeted, Aries, and the Brisk also Taurus sign. Aries and Taurus sign. Okay, so Aries and Taurus sign, they are put into Chatuspada category. This is, I mean, you can go through my lecture series 3. There I have discussed about all these things in detail. Now I am taking them briefly so that one can understand that what does it mean, how they are meshed. So this is Vashyakuti. Now comes to Tarakut, third one. So third point is Tarakut. 3 points are allotted to Tarakut. How Tarakut is decided about? Tarakut is decided about if we count the nakshatra of the one person and second. Suppose this is one person, second person. Mr. Modi is first person and Sardar Patel is second person, or second is Mr. Modi and first is Sardar Patel. Vice versa we will take. So what we have to do? Count from nakshatra of one person to nakshatra of another person where moon is positioned. Moon is positioned in which nakshatra? So nakshatra of one person, count from there to another person. Suppose person's moon is in Ashwini Nakshatra, which is one, which is put into the Irishan, or Ashwini Nakshatra is first number. And the second person is born in Rohini Nakshatra. So Ashwini, Bharani, Kritika, Rohini, fourth. So these are the 1 to 4. So 1 to 4, both are included. So 1 to 4 means 4. If 4 is divided by 9 and divide those total sum of those two numbers, I mean count from one chatra to another chatra, and both numbering are included. Okay, 1 and 4 both are included. So 1 to 4 means 4 only. So this 4 is divided by 9. If remainder means says for the remaining thing after division of 9. How many times 9 is dividing this? But because 4 cannot be divided by 9, so 4 is the remainder only. So 4 remainder remains. So if remainder is 5, 3, 7, I've written down here 3, 5, 7. That means if remainder is 3, 5, 7, then is malefic. Nakshatra, that will be then malefic. So 0 point will be given. If other than 3, 5, 7, the remainder is there, so for example, in this case, 4 is the remainder. If 1 to 4, one person is born in Ashwini Nakshatra, other is born in Rohini Nakshatra, 1 to 4 count, it will be 1 to 4 means 4 only. So 4 divided by 9 is 4. And if I count from Rohini Nakshatra to Aries Nakshatra, I mean this Ashwini Nakshatra, so from 4 to 27, from 27 to then 1. So total 28 in this case. So 28 minus 4 means 24. Sorry. So 24 is the total sum. If 24 divided by 9, if you count from 4, from second person, suppose second person is born in Rohini Nakshatra, first is born in Ashwini Nakshatra. So first count from one person to second person, then from second person to first person, both ways. From first to second and second to first. Second to first means 4th to 4, 5, 6, 7 up to 27, then come to 1. So 1 is then 28th one. So 4 to 28th, 28 divided by 4, subtracted 4, you will get 24. Then 24 is the total divided by 9 then. 9 to 18, 9 to 27, but 9 to 18 means 6 is the remainder. So 6 is still positive is there. I mean, the remainder is not 3, 5, 7. If a remainder is 3, 5, 7, then 0 point is allotted. If otherwise, then 7 point is allotted. So in this case, 7 points are given to, sorry, this, 3 points are given. 3 points, and if vice versa, if suppose from both sides, 1.5 point is given. Suppose from one side it is positive, and from other side it is 3, 5, 7. But in this case, 4 and second by 6, so in both way, 1.5 point is given. From first point to second point, if I count, then remainder after division by 9, the remainder is supposed 3, 0 point is allotted. And suppose from another side, for 4 to, if I counted from 4 to 1, then it was 28, 28 minus 4, that means 24. 24 divided by this one, 9 is remainder 6. But 6 is for 6, complete, full marks, 1.5 point will be given. So both ways we have to count, and 1.5 point, 1.5 point is allotted. And from one side, if it is 0, remainder is 3, 5, 7, then 0 is given, and only 1.5 point will be there in that case. But in this situation, both people are born in the same nakshatra, Anuradha nakshatra, which is 17th one. So Anuradha nakshatra to Anuradha nakshatra. From one person to another person, only one. So 1 divided by 9 is 1 remainder. So if 1 remainder is there, then complete marks 1.5 from one side. Other side, if you count from Anuradha to Anuradha, that is 1 only. So from both way, 1 is the remainder. So 1.5 point plus 1.5 point, total 3 points are given. Okay, so from both sides, first to second person, second to first person, we have to count the nakshatra numbers. And both nakshatras are included. First nakshatra is included, then fourth is also included. So in this way we have to count. 1, 2 up to 4 means in this case 4 is only. But from 4 to 1 if I count, then it will be 28, not 27. But 4 to 27 if I count, it will be 23, and then 1 more, it will be 24. Because up to 1 if I count, then it will be 24. So 24 divided by 9. So in both ways we have to count nakshatra to nakshatra. from first person nakshatra to second person nakshatra, from second person nakshatra to first person nakshatra, means go ahead and after. Yes friends, so here we were talking about third point. This is the third point. Now what is the development of this? Now in this case, intensity of relationship will be there. If Tarakut is matching, the person is having 3 points out of 3 points undoubtedly. Then intensity of relationship means the people will like each other's activity, each other's character, everything will be liked by another person. Undoubtedly, Mr. Modi is so much interested in Sardar Patelji that he constructed his horoscope. He arranged all the things and he constructed his statue. So that is how the person is, I mean, both are interested. If two people are running the same, in this case, country is being run by both the country. He ran the country in 1947 to 50, and now he is running the country. I mean, Mr. Modi is running the country. So, running of the country is a quality. Both are having similar type of activities. Yes, they are having similar kind of activities. If these qualities are matching, these gunas are matching, a good winner if I do. And on the basis of these matchings, we always decide about the people's activities, their characteristics to each other. I mean, both are like each other or not. In this case, both people are just, you know, similar to each other because they are born in the same nakshatra, only quarters are different. First is born in second, I mean, Mr. Modi is born in second quarter. Sardarji is born in, Sardar Patelji is born in the third quarter. So this is the only difference, otherwise all the things are equivalent. But some are there because one person is having fourth Leo sign, fourth sign, I mean son of the fourth lord of Sardar Patelji has gone to the debilitation sign, the sixth house, Libra sign, which is in debilitation sign for son. So because of that his demotion was there, I mean he couldn't get highest position, but he was demoted to deputy prime ministership because it has gone to the because fourth house represents the position of a person, promotion of a person. So he didn't get promotion, but he was demoted to deputy prime minister. So that I've already discussed about. Now come to the point. So we were discussing about third point. We have talked about Tarakut. So Tarakut is decided on the basis of counting of nakshatra from one person to another person. And then after that, so what is the signification of this? That they are intensity of relationship. These two people will search for each other. I mean, suppose both were living people. I mean, Sardar Patelji was also living nowadays. Then both were be interested to each other. They will like each other so much that they will search their qualities, their readings, activities, everything they will like. Okay, so he will search his inheritance and everything, that where you study, where you went there, this and that. So all the things they will search for each other from each other's activities. This is how the people's horoscopes should be matched. Only then we have to decide about whether they can run the country, they can run a company, they can run a house in a better manner or not. So this is the process of how our rishis have decided to match the horoscopes of the couple which is going to marry. Okay, so the same process is done for two brother, to any two people, any two family members, any two people who are running a business, who are staying in a rented house. Suppose a rented house is taken by two people, but they are fighting with each other, and after some time they will just go away. They will be separated. So loss of money will be there and this and that, or they can kill each other. So in that way, so to save that activity of theirs, we have to match the horoscope first. And after that, we just, you know, suggest them that this is a bad activity. You have to, you know, change yourself. Otherwise, you will have this kind of problems in your life. This is how the matching of horoscope is done. Now, on the basis of this, Ashtakut Milan, eight kind of qualities or eight kind of virtues are being judged on the basis of this. So third, I have taken. Now fourth one, Yoni Kut. Now there are, 27 nakshatras, but one nakshatra, Abhijit nakshatra, is being taken out from one nakshatra and another nakshatra, means 21st nakshatra is the Uttar Ashad nakshatra and 22nd is Shravan nakshatra. So one part, I mean the fourth quarter of Uttar Ashad nakshatra and Shravan nakshatra is 1 upon 15th part, about 53 degree 20 minute. They are taken 53 minute and 20 seconds. This much amount, if you divide 30 degree 20 minute by 15, you will obtain 53 minutes and 20 seconds, about 20 seconds, 19.999 seconds. So 53 minutes and 20 seconds. If we add into 10 degree, so 10 degree, because one quarter of Uttar Shadha Nakshatra will be in the Capricorn sign, okay? The 10th sign, 21st Nakshatra will lie in the 10th sign Capricorn. So that is from 60 degree, 40 minutes, plus 3 degree, 20 minutes. So this 3 degree 20 minute in these two quarters and 3 degree 20 minute the fourth quarter of Uttar Shadha Nakshatra. So 3 degree 20 minute of Uttar Shadha Nakshatra and plus 1.15th part, this is Uttar Shadha Nakshatra, 3 degree 20 minute, fourth quarter, last quarter. Okay, fourth quarter of Uttar Shadha Nakshatra and 1.15th portion or four ghatis, this is four ghatis, or 1.15th part of Shravan Nakshatra, which comes out to be, if I divide 13 degree 20 minute total strength of one nakshatra, of Shravan Nakshatra by 15, we will obtain 53 minute and 20 seconds. Okay, so from 10 degree, because 6 degree 40 minute plus 3 degree 20 minute, so 10 degree, so from this 6 degree 40 minute, 6 degree 40 minute, 10 degree, because 3 degree 20 minutes plus 6 degree 40 minutes is 10 degree, 53 minutes and 20 seconds. 10 degree, 53 minutes to 20 and 20 seconds. This is the Capricorn sign, Abhijit Nakshatra will lie. Abhijit Nakshatra is, you may say 22nd Nakshatra in this case. Then Shravan Nakshatra is now 23rd one, okay. And after that, total so 28 Nakshatra are just now formed. Abhijit Nakshatra is being formed, is being framed, you may say, by the rishis, just to put into two categories to make 14 yonis. These are the 14 yoni. The fourth one is of yoni. What are the yoni here? Yoni is, you know, number of people are just so miscalculating, misinterpreting yoni, this yoni, ling and yoni and this and that. What kind of, you know, miscalculation they are doing? They are just, you know, taking that in a wrong way. But yoni means the person who is born in which yoni, in which living thing, in which living, you know, person or living insect or living this and that. So what are those yoni? There are 14 yonis. A person is born in a particular yoni, for example, Banar yoni, Gaj yoni, Singh yoni, Gau yoni, okay, and Marjar yoni. Marjar means cat, and then Mushak yoni, rat. Mushak means rat, rat yoni, okay, Mushak yoni, Gau yoni, Marjar yoni, then Nakul means, you know, mongoose, Nebla yoni, and enemy of Nebla is serpent. And serpent yoni, enemy is Nakul, means mongoose. Similarly, for cow or goa yoni, for goa yoni, who is the tiger is the, or Vyagra yoni, tiger is Vyagra yoni. Person, if he is born in a particular nakshatra, then he will be put into Vyagra yoni. So suppose the two persons who are born in enemical yonis, then they are not going to survive with each other. They will fight with each other, they can, you know, kill each other, or either of them will be killed. So this is how this matching is based on the yoni. In which yoni a person, particular person is born. Okay, suppose the two people are going to marry, a couple is going to marry, one boy and girl, then their horoscope are matched. If they are of the different yoni which are enemical to each other. Now I put here, there are 14 yonis and they are bitter enemies. Bitter yoni and bitter enemy, yoni bitter enemy. What are the nakshatra? Two nakshatra. In this way, 28 nakshatra are made. Okay, 28 nakshatra, and those 28 nakshatra are put into two categories. So, two nakshatra are put into one yoni, two nakshatra are in second yoni. In this way, 14 yonis are formed. Which are those 14 yoni? If a person is born in a particular nakshatra, for example, these two leaders are born in Anuradha nakshatra, and Anuradha nakshatra is in Mrga yoni. Mrga means deer, heron, okay, heron yoni, Mrga yoni, and they are born in drug, this deer yoni, Mrga yoni. Anuradha nakshatra is put into drug yoni, and then who is the bitter enemy of drug, this is deer? Rear bitter yoni, sorry, bitter enemy is Swan, dog. Okay, so dog, Ardra Nakshatra and Mula Nakshatra. If a person is born in Ardra Nakshatra and Mula Nakshatra, that person is born in a Swan yoni, dog yoni. So this person, if he is, you know, living together with this person or they are running a country, they cannot run. They will fight with each other. Mula Nakshatra and Ardra Nakshatra born people are known as Swan Yoni born, Swan Yoni, Dog Yoni. And Deer Yoni is Jeshta Nakshatra and Anuradha Nakshatra. Anuradha Jeshta, 17th and 18th Nakshatra. These two Nakshatra are put into Mraga Yoni. Okay, Mraga Deer Yoni. So these two people are born in Deer Yoni. So because they are born in the same Nakshatra, so their Yoni is Mraga Yoni. And because of that, they are given total marks 4 out of 4. 4 out of 4. What is the development of this? Latent characteristics. They will have whatever the hidden characteristics are there, they will be, you know, there. I mean, they will recognize each other's hidden characteristics. One person can tell other person that you are having this kind of, you know, inheritance quality or inherited quality or some latent quality, hidden quality of yours. I understand what is your hidden quality. They can understand each other very, very much, you know, deeply. Deep understanding of each other's qualities are there. This is how latent characteristics are very much matching with each other. This is how fourth yoni, because they are born in the same yoni. Same yoni means their activities are similar. Drug yoni, this is deer, sorry. Drug I'm talking about always. Deer yoni. Deer yoni means heron, mrag yoni. So they are born in the mrag yoni. Now let me take these 14 yoni, which are bitter enemies of these two. Now, bitter enemy people, suppose the person is born in bitter enemy nakshatra, then these two people cannot run together. So, in this way, this matching is done scientifically to 100%. The people who are just, you know, born in different enemical yonis, they are not going to survive with each other and they are put into different names. So person can understand that in which yoni a person is born. So these are the 14 yoni, let me name them or I mean cite their names. First is if a person is born in Ashwini Nakshatra and Shatvishaj Nakshatra. Second is Shatvishaj. These two nakshatras are put into Ashwa yoni, horse yoni. Ashwa yoni means horse yoni. Right? Ashwa yoni. Who is bitter enemy of this? The bitter enemy of this is a buffalo yoni, or that is known as Mahish yoni. Mahish means buffalo. Mahish is Sanskrit word. Mahish yoni. Mahish yoni. Buffalo yoni. So buffalo is a bitter enemy of Ashwa yoni. These two are, these two people are matched together. What is the Mahish yoni? Mahish yoni or Buffalo yoni, which are those two nakshatras. So the second are taken Swati nakshatra and Hasta nakshatra. Swati nakshatra and Hasta nakshatra, both are of Brahman Varna, right? Ganam, Dev Gana, Ashwini nakshatra, Swati nakshatra and Hasta nakshatra. They are of Dev Gana. These two people are of Mahish yoni. If a person is born in a Mahish yoni, Swati nakshatra or in Hasta nakshatra, then the person is born in Mahish yoni, Buffalo yoni. And for this, if a person, another person, second person who is going to run the business, run the country, if that person is being matched with this person, and that person's nakshatra, moon is positioned in which nakshatra, Ashwini nakshatra or Shatvishaj nakshatra. Ashwini is Devgana, but Shatvishaj nakshatra is Shatvishaj nakshatra is Rakshasgana. Okay, so Rakshasgana nakshatra. So if these two people are matched together, Ashwini and Swati and Hasta, they cannot, match with each other. They will fight with each other. They cannot cooperate with each other. So cooperation will not be there. Okay, so this fourth point is giving yoni nakshatra, latent characteristics they are sharing. So next, let me cite the other yonis. If Dhanishta nakshatra, this is Dhanishta third one, Dhanishta nakshatra and Purva Bhadrapada. These two nakshatra, if a person is born, moon is in these two nakshatra, that is Singh yoni or loin yoni or Singh yoni. This one is Singh yoni and the Gaj yoni, elephant, Gaj yoni. So elephant is bitter enemy of this. Elephant is bitter enemy. Now bitter enemy, this is yoni. Bitter enemy is elephant or gajyoni. So gajyoni people, what is gajyoni? Which two nakshatras are put into gajyoni? So gajyoni is the fourth one, bharani nakshatra and revati nakshatra. So bharani nakshatra and revati nakshatra, the moon is the line of a person. That person is born in gajyoni, elephant yoni or gajyoni. So this elephant's enemy, bitter enemy is lion, singh rasi or singh yoni. So singh yoni people who are born in the third one, dhanushya nakshatra and purvghatipa nakshatra, that person is of leo yoni, okay, or singh yoni. So that singh yoni person is bitter enemy to gajyoni people. And then fifth one, pushya nakshatra and kritika nakshatra. These two nakshatras are put into ram yoni. Ram means male's yoni, male's first rasi, male's rasi. That means ram yoni. Ram means he sheep, mada. So that mada is ram. So ram yoni, or that's known as mesh yoni. Mesh yoni enemy is monkey, vanara yoni. Vanara yoni, person who is, what is the vanara yoni? Vanara yoni nakshatra ka sixth one, shravana nakshatra and purva ashada nakshatra. Purva ashada and shravana nakshatra, they are put into vanara yoni. A person who is, whose moon is lying in the Shravana Chhatra or in Purva Ashadana Chhatra, Purva Ashad, that person is born in Vanara Yoni, Vanara Yoni or Monkey Yoni. Bitter enemy is again Ram, Mesh. So Mesh Yoni people are bitter enemy of these two. So these are the, how we have discussed about these 14 Yoni. Let me take the seventh one, Uttara Ashad and Abhishna Chhatra. They are put in Nakul Yoni. Nakul means Nebla, Mangoose. Mangujyoni, person who is born in, moon is in Uttarasad, Purvasad was in sixth, that was Vanara Yoni, Purvasad, Uttarasad is then put into Nakulyoni, Mangujyoni, Nakul. And this one, Rohini and Mrikshara, sorry, this one. Uttarasad and Abhijit Nishatra, which I just framed from 21st Nishatra, Uttarasad and Shravan. Uttarasad and Shravan, in between, there is Abhijit Nakshatra. As I have told you, that what is Abhijit Nakshatra, the degree of Abhijit Nakshatra is in Capricorn sign. So Abhijit Nakshatra and this one, Uttarasad Nakshatra, Uttarasad, from Uttarasad only the Abhijit Nakshatra is formed. Right? So Shravan Nakshatra was in the first one, that was in Vanara Yoni, Shravan Nakshatra and Uttarasad Nakshatra. So these two Nakshatras are framing the Abhijit Nakshatra. So Abhijit Nakshatra is put into Nakul Yoni, Mangoose Yoni, Nakul. Nakul means Nebla, Mangoose, Nakul Yoni. And for this, bitter enemy is Serpent, okay, Sarp Yoni. So Sarp Yoni person, who is Sarp Yoni? Rohini Nakshatra and Mrikshara Nakshatra. Rohini Nakshatra and Mrikshara Nakshatra person born, if his moon is in Rohini Nakshatra or Mrikshara Nakshatra, then that person is born in Sarp Yoni. So Sarp Yoni is given to Rohini Nakshatra and Mrikshara Nakshatra. If moon is lying in these two nakshatras, that is Serpent Yoni. And again, Nakul or Mangoose Yoni, that person is, those nakshatras are enemy to these two. Serpent and Nakul. Nebla and Sarp, that you know about, that Nakul can kill Serpent or kill Sarp. So Sarp and Nakul or Mangoose, Nebla, they are enemy to each other. So Nakul and Sarp, and Nakul and Serpent, so that are taken together. Okay, then up to 8th we have discussed for them. 9th is Jyeshtha Nakshatra and Anuradha Nakshatra. Anuradha Nakshatra, as I have just talked about. So these two leaders are born in Anuradha Nakshatra. So Jyeshtha Nakshatra and Anuradha Nakshatra, 9th one. As I have already talked about Jyeshtha Nakshatra, which is the 18th one, and 17th one is Anuradha Nakshatra. So these two are put into same category, which is known as Deer or Mrigs Yoni, Mrig Yoni. Deer Yoni, right? Heron Yoni or Mrig Yoni, deer. Deer Yoni, who is a bitter enemy of this? Dog, swan Yoni, swan means dog, dog Yoni. Dog is bitter enemy. So dog is formed by which two nakshatras? I have next put Mool Nakshatra and Ardra Nakshatra. So those people who are born in, with moon in Ardra Nakshatra or Mool Nakshatra, Mool is Rakshasgana and Ardra is Manushyagana. So these two people who are born in this, these two nakshatras, okay, they are bitter enemy to Mrigayoni, Jyeshtha nakshatra and Anuradha nakshatra, dear yoni, this is Mrigayoni, and for that bitter enemy is Shwan yoni or dog yoni. Shwan yoni people are those whose moon is lying in Mool nakshatra and Ardha nakshatra, 10th one. I have put here 10th one, dog or deer. So they are bitter enemy to each other. Then 11th is Punarvasu nakshatra and Ashlesha nakshatra. If a person is born in these two nakshatras, Ashlesha, if their moon is lying in Punarvasu and Ashlesha, that person is born is cat yoni, Marjari yoni. That means Marjari yoni. Marjari means cat. Just like cat, they are just, you know, attention is just like cat. They are just, activity are just like cat like. That is Marjari yoni. In Sanskrit, it is known Marjari means cat. Delhi, right? So that is cat yoni. So Punarvasu and Ashlesha nakshatra, they are put in cat category or cat yoni, that is Marjari yoni. And for that, you got Mushak, rat, that is bitter enemy. So cat and rat, they cannot live together. So cat and rat, they are bitter enemy to each other. And rat or Mushak yoni, for Mushak yoni, which are the two nakshatras, next 12th one, Magha nakshatra and Purva Phaguni and Magha nakshatra. These two are put into Mushak yoni or cat yoni. For that, naturally, rat is, sorry, this cat is, or Marjari is, Marjari yoni people are bitter enemy. So those nakshatras are put, just understand them, that moon, if it, of a person is put into one category, person is born in one nakshatra, not in two nakshatra, a moon is lying in one nakshatra, in which nakshatra the person is lying or is born, that nakshatra is to be understood. And then another person who is going to be matched with this person, they are going to live together, they are going to run a company, they are going to start a business house or start a, or they are going to live in a rented house, they are going to run the country, then those two leaders are to be matched together, only then they can run the party in a better manner. Otherwise they will fight with each other and they will be separated. And you can just understand, I have, you know, matched almost all the leaders of the present time. I understand that which person is just fighting with each other, cannot live together. If you match the horoscope of Mr. Modi and with Mr. Nitish Kumar, you will find totally different. I have just matched that. I'll just discuss about that later. Well, they cannot live together. They will always, you know, they are having, I mean, one person is having evil mind always against the other one. No one, these two people cannot survive, cannot live together. So, the same way, as leaders are being checked, being matched, as the two people who are going to marry, their horoscopes are matched before marriage just to save their life. Their married life should be saved, that should be a comfortable one, that should be a very peaceful one. Similarly, the country should be run by the people who are matching together. If they are understood, they can understand this, a Devgan person can understand the Rakshasgan person. But Rakshasgan person cannot understand the Devgan person. He will fight, he will always separate. He will, you know, try to apply all kinds of activities just to run down another person. This is the activity of a Rakshasgan person. And you will find that which are the people who are Rakshasgan people, which are born in which nakshatra. So nakshatra are put into different categories. Different ganas that I will discuss about. Gana is 6th point, I think. Gan Kut is 6th one. That I will discuss. Now from the point. So the yonis I was discussing about 12th. This rat and cat I have discussed about. Tiger yoni, Vishakha nakshatra and Chitra nakshatra. Chitra nakshatra and Vishakha is Chitra, 13th one. So second last is 13th yoni, which is this tiger yoni or Vyagra yoni. Tiger, the person if he is born in Vishakha nakshatra and Chitra nakshatra, they are tiger like. They are just, you know, always crying like, just, you know, so much, aggressive people they are. So this person if he is messed with a cow. Cow is bitter enemy to tiger or Vyagra. Naturally, Vyagra yoni and cow yoni or go yoni, they cannot, live together. What is cow yoni? Uttar Bhadrapada nakshatra and Uttar Phaguni nakshatra. Uttar Bhadrapada and Uttar Phaguni nakshatra born people are born in go yoni or cow yoni. For cow, tiger or Vyagra yoni people are totally enemical. So they cannot live together. For this, these matching zero will be allotted. If they are together, these people are differently born, for enemy connect this one, then 0 points will be allocated. But in this case, 4 out of 4 points, because they are born in the same yoni, mrig yoni, deer yoni, Angad Nakshatra is then, as I have just talked about, Angad Nakshatra. Okay, this one, Angad Nakshatra was here. This one, Angad, ninth one. Jyeshtha Nakshatra, Angad Nakshatra is put into deer yoni or mrig yoni. Mrig yoni, deer, heron. Okay, so mrig yoni or deer yoni, right? So these two people are born in the same yoni. Dragyoni, this Mrigyoni or deer yoni. So for them, dog Shwana yoni people are enmical. They cannot live together. So 0 point. If the second person is of Shwana yoni, other is of Mrigyoni, then 0 point will be allocated. But in this case, 4 point because they are born in the same yoni, Mrigyoni, same nakshatra is born. They are born in the same nakshatra, so Mrigyoni. So 4 points are. Then is Graha Koot, Graha Maitri Koot. It is simply because the lord of the sign in which moon is positioned, the lord of that sign, the two people's moon signs, lord, are friendly, are enemical or neutral. That depends upon them. But in this case, both are born in the same sign, Scorpio sign. Lord is Mars, Mangal. Mangal ki rasi, Scorpio, Vrishchik rasi. They are born in Vrishchik rasi. So this is Graha Maitri Koot. So for that 5 points are allotted, 5 out of 5. If it is, not Maitri, they are enemical, 0 points is given. Enemy, bitter enemy. For example, Mars and Saturn, enemical. Okay, but Sun and Venus are enemical. Okay, similarly, but Sun, Jupiter, Sun, Mars, Sun, Moon, friendly. Okay, they are friendly planets. So lord of the signs in which Moon is positioned, the sign lord, are enemical, are friendly, are neutral. That we have to discuss about. And that I have already discussed about in lecture number 3. Please see that. They are enemical relationship, friendly, which planets are friendly to each other. For Moon, how many friends are there? For Moon, Mars and Sun and Jupiter, friendly and neutral mostly. Others are neutral. No enemical, but neutral mostly. Others are neutral for Moon. And for Saturn, Sun, Jupiter is neutral, but Sun, Mars and Moon, enemical, and friendly are Venus and Mercury. Venus and Mercury are friendly to Saturn. So if the lord of that sign in which Moon is positioned, the lord of that sign is friendly to another person's Moon sign, then for complete point are given. But in this case, because both are born in the Scorpio sign, and Moon is positioned in the Scorpio sign, so lord of that is Mars. Mars for both are same. The same lord is there. Suppose one person is born in Aries sign, lord of Aries sign is also Mars. And another person is born in the Scorpio sign, lord of Scorpio sign is also Mars. Both are friendly. In that case also, 5 points out of 5 points will be allotted. This is known as Graha Maitri Koot, right? Then Gan Koot. As I have told you that there are three kinds of Ganas. Devgana, Rakshas Gana, Devgana, Manushgana, Rakshas Gana. So 9 nakshatras put out of 27 nakshatras, they are put into three categories. Devgana, Manushgana, Rakshas Gana. How? They have to be, talked about Ashwini nakshatra, Devgana. Ashwini Bharani is Manushgana. Ashwini Bharani Kritika is Rakshas Gana. Ashwini Bharani Kritika Rohini is Manushgana. And Ashwini Bharani Kritika Rohini Mrikshara is Devgana. Ashwini Bharani Kritika Rohini Mrikshara Ardra Manushgana. Pushya Manush Devgana. Ashwini Bharani Kritika Rohini Mrikshara Ardra Pundavashu Devgana. Pushya Pushya Devgana. Then so in this way we can write down these three categories. So but these three people are born in the Angad Nakshatra. Sorry, Angad Nakshatra is of Devgana. Right? Devgana people. Both are in same Gana, then complete points are given, full points are given, 6 points out of 6 points are allotted these two people. So similarly, if the person is Devgana and Rakshasa Gana, 0 points. Cannot be. If one person is Devgana, other is Rakshasa Gana, 1 point can be allotted because Devgana can adjust it to Rakshasa Gana, but Rakshasa Gana cannot adjust it with Devgana. So if Rakshasgan person is to compare with another person who is Devgana, 0 point is allotted in that case. Okay, so for Rakshasgan Devgana, 0 point is allotted. In this way, Naina Nakshatra, that these see there, I can put, I can write that if I just write down here. So, I mean, gana, how do we decide gana? Devgana, manushgana, rakshasgana, if I put here. Let me write here Devgana. Devgana, manushgana, manushgana and rakshasgana. How do you nachatra put? Naina nachatra put into this one. First is Asuni nachatra, Bharani nachatra, manushgana and Kritika nachatra of rakshasgana. Now Asuni, Bharani, let me write Bharani, Ardra, and Rohini. Out of these three nachatras, Bharani, Ardra, and Rohini, Rohini. The other are Uttarasar, Uttar Uttar. There are three Uttarasar, Uttar Fauni, Uttar Fauni, Uttar Fauni, Uttar Bhadrapad. Uttar Bhadrapad. Similarly, Purv Asar, Purv. Purva Ashad, Purva Mahatripada, Purva Fauni. So these three plus these three are put into Manushyagana. And Devgan, Ashni, I have written down here. Bharani Kritika is here, Kritika. Rohini is here. Ashni, Bharani Kritika, Rohini. Mirkshara. Mirkshara is your Devgan. Mirkshara. Right? Ashni, Bharani Kritika, Rohini, Mirkshara. Then Ardra is of Manushyagana, Ardra, I put here. Ashni, Bharani, Kritika, Rohini, Mirsa, Ardra, Pundravasu. Pundravasu nachatra. Okay? Pundravasu is of this Rakshasgana, Pundravasu. Ashni, Bharani, Kritika, Rohini, Mirsa, Ardra, Pundravasu, Pushya of Devgana. Ashni, Bharani, Kritika, Rohini, Mirsa, Ardra, Pundravasu, Pushya, Asalesha, Rakshasgana. Asulesha, Pushya Asulesha, then Magha, Magha is also of Rakshasgana. Ashni Bharani Kritika Rohini Mirsa Ardra Pundravasu Pushya Asulesha Magha, Purva Fauni, Uttara Fauni, they are put in Manushyagana, Uttavani Astar Hasta, Hasta is of Devgana, Chitra is of Rakshasgana, Chitra Andhada, Devgana, Anuradha, Jeshta then is of Rakshasgana. Another Jeshta, Mula Rakshasgana. Pur Faguni, Uttar Faguni, Hasta Chitra Swati, I have taken Vishaka, Andhada, Jeshta, Mula, Purvashar, Uttarsha, Shravan, Shravan is of Devgana. Shravan, Ashwini, okay, Shravan. Then Mula Purvani Tavani Hasta Chitta Swati Vishakandala Nishta Mula Purvasha Shravan Dhanishta Dhanishta Rakshasgana Shravan Dhanishta Shatavishta Rakshasgana okay, Shravan Chitra Devana Revati is Devana last one okay, and Shravan Dhanishta Shatavishta Purvhatpa Uttarvhatpa Revati Revati is also of Devana. In this way, nine nachatras are put. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Two more were there. Maybe I have taken here Pundravasu, maybe Devgana. Or that you can imagine also. These nine nachatras are put into these three categories. Okay? I can just, keep them if I am just remembering. So, just start to just put them, but it may take time. But you can go through my lecture series 3, in which I have discussed about all these ganas. Devgana, Manushyagana, Rakshasgana. Manushyagana is 100% true. For these three, Bharani Nachatra, Ardha Nachatra and Rohini Nachatra. Other than these three, Purva Nachatras and three Uttara Nachatras, Uttara Sad, Uttara Faguni, Uttara Bhadrapada. Similarly, Purva Sad, Purva Faguni, Purva Bhadrapada. So these six plus Rohini and Ardha and Bharani, these are put into Manushyagana. So those people who are having moon in their three nachatras, they are born in Manushyagana. So Manushyagana person cannot survive the Rakshasgana people. Rakshasgana nachatras are Kritika, okay, Asalesha, Jeshta, Chitra, Magha, they are of Rakshasgana. So I mean, I can write all those things. You can just go through my lecture number 3, where I discuss about all these things. So these are the ganakut. So if the person is born in the same gana, that is 100% true, that must be, said okay, because those people will have the same qualities. What is Devgan person are very controllable, they have patience, they understand each other, they are very logical, they respect their guru, their teacher, their scripture, they are very classical people, traditional people, they understand everything religiously, they respect their parents and everything. Okay, they can take knowledge from even their enemies, are being respected by them even. Okay, so Devgan people are so much sound in knowledge, sound in everything, they are not aggressive. Rakshasana are aggression, patience less. They can kill others if they are not agreed with their ideas. So they want to be superpower others. They are very aggressive people. Patience less, lack of patience is there in Rakshasana people. So those differences I've already discussed about, I think lecture series 3 and onwards. So these ganas I'll take later if I find the time. But in this case, I've just talked about that how these ganas are decided about. The person is of the same gana, 100% true. But Devgana and Manushya gana can run together. Okay? But Devgana, Rakshas gana will fight with each other. If Manushya gana can run with Devgana, but Manushya gana cannot run with Rakshas gana, they will kill each other. But Devgana and Rakshas gana will fight with each other. Cannot agree logically different. Will fight with each other. They cannot agree. Okay? And Manushya gana and Devgana can run, okay, because Manushyagan will respect Devgan people. Devgan people have sound, skilled worker, they have some very deep knowledge. Because of that, they are respectful. Devgan people are being respected by Manushyagan people. So this is how Nakshatra are divided into three categories. Otherwise, all those things, Dev, Rakshas and all these things, people are just taking lot of negative points from Vedic dharmas or religious things or religious things, nothing else. Only astrologically these things are being defined by Devgan, Rakshas and Manushyagana. And the people, categories are being divided. That is 100% to three types of people, Devgan type, Rakshas and Manushyagana type of people. Only these three categories people can be found. Okay, so they are adjustable, not adjustable. There are different kinds of other points we will discuss later. Next is seventh one is Rasikut. What is Rasikut here? If I count the moon's rasi, moon's sign, in which moon is posited in one person, of another person. If the two persons counting, if I suppose the person is born in Tula, Libra sign, second person is born in Virgo sign, 6 and 7. So 6 and 7 points are 2nd and 12 to each other. 2nd and 12 to each other. The person, one person who is the, the person who is wealthy person, who is the major person to run a business, or maybe either, for example, Prime Minister and a Deputy Prime Minister, these two people are having, one person, the superior one is having, 2nd sign or 12th sign, their moon is lying in 12th sign, second sign. 12th sign, second means houses wise. Suppose the lagna is here, then 12th sign is having 6th sign, and the lagna is having Libra sign, 7th sign, and 6th sign is in 12th house. So 12 to 2, 12. This is not 12 to 12. If I count from 12 number, 12th house, then first house is 2nd house. And from 2nd house, 12th house is 12th house. In this case, 12 and so in this way, moon's position in two different signs which are together, 6 and 2 and 12 not considered good, malefic, 0 point is allotted. And then 5 and 9 position, if moons of the two people are 5-9 position, from one person it is 5, another person it is 9, so this 5 and 9 position is also not good. 6 and 8 position, if moon is lying in 6th and 8th position of the two people, okay, signs. Moon is positioned in a particular sign, if that sign count from another person's sign, and then their counting comes to be 6 and 8. From one person it is 6th sign, 6th rasi or 6th house, and another person's count from moon position to another person's moon, it is the 8th sign or 8th house. In this way, 6th, 8th position is also not considered good. They will fight with each other, they will have totally different ideas, cannot coexist. That is what the position of this Rasi could be there. So, but in this case, both are born in the same sign, Okay, same house, same sign. Same house, not same house, but same sign. This position of sign. Eighth sign is there. The moon of Sadhar Pradesh is also in the eighth sign, Scorpio sign. And Mr. Modi is also in the eighth sign, Scorpio sign, which is in the Lagna. So from moon's position to 100% moon's position, it's the same 0 point because they are lying in the same sign, same house. So for that, 7 out of 7 points are there. Okay, so they are having same. For this is what is the significance? Mutual adjustment. Their adaptability is there. They will be adjustable to each other. Mutual adjustment will be there if these two people were living together, running the country same. Okay, they are same leaders, then they can be adjustable. Mutual adjustability is there. Mutual adjustment is there. Or adaptability. Adaptability is adjustable. They can adjust with each other. No, there will be no fighting. And they will be just no liking each other. This are mutual adjustment or mutual adaptability will be the 7 point. So 7 point out of 7 point. Now so far as Nadi Kut is concerned, Nadi Kut in this case, Nadi Dosh is there if the people are having same Nadi. What are the Nadis? Adi Nadi, Madhya Nadi, Ant Nadi. So 9 nakshatras put into the three, again, the three Nadis. Adi Nadi, Ant Nadi, Madhya Nadi and Ant Nadi. Three Nadis are there. These people are born in Madhya Nadi. Because their Angara nakshatra is put into Madhya Nadi. How the Nadis are kept? Simple. If you put from Adi Nadi, Madhya Nadi and Ant Nadi. So if you count from first one, Adi Nadi. So Ashvi nakshatra, Bharani nakshatra, then Kritika and Ardra, Kritika and Rohini. Ashni, Bharani, Kritika, Rohini, the two together, they are put into the Ant Nadi. Then come to the Manushyagana. So Ashni, Bharani, Kritika, Rohini as well in the third one. Then after Rohini, the fifth one is in the Manushyagana. Then the sixth one and seventh one, the two together in the first one. Then seventh one, sixth and seventh, okay. Then eighth one is in the Manushyagana, the middle one, Madhya Nadi. Third one is then Ant Nadi. So first one was Adi Nadi. So if I put these three, let me write them, how these Nadis are kept. So if they are born in the same Nadi, Nadi those will be there. The Nadi must be different Nadis. The person, Nakshatra, must be lying in the different Nadi. If they are lying in the same Nadi, then there are conditions. If they are born in the same Nakshatra, for example, then their Nadi, those is there, means their Nadi is the same. For example, these people are born in the Andhra Nakshatra. Andhra Nakshatra is put into Madhya Nadi. But conditions are there. If the persons are born in the same Nakshatra, but quarters are different, as in this case, so Nadi dosh will not be considered so bad. In this case, Nadi dosh is not there. Even I can put here 8 out of 8 points. So total 36 points are matching of these two leaders. So they are matching with 36 points together because in Nakshatra, same Nakshatra, they are born in different quarters. They are born in the same Nakshatra, undoubtedly Nadi dosh is there. But the conditions are given that if Nadi dosh, if the people are born in the same Nakshatra, then Nakshatra is if in different quarters, they are born in different quarters, not in same quarter. If they are on the same quarter of the nakshatra, then there is Nadi dosh. So 0 point out of 8 points will be given. As in this case, I have taken here just to tell the people that how this Nadi dosh is being counted. If the people are born the same nakshatra, but nakshatra is lying in the two different signs, okay? If nakshatra is because some nakshatras are lying in the two rasis, two signs. Two different signs, two rasi, two different signs. For example, Ashwini, Bharani, Kritika. Kritika nakshatra is lying in Aries sign as well as in Bharani, Aries and second sign, Taurus sign. So Aries and Taurus sign. So nakshatra, third one, Kritika nakshatra is lying in the first quarter of Kritika nakshatra is lying in the Aries sign and second, third and fourth quarter, three quarters are lying in the Taurus sign. So in this way, nakshatra is same, but rasis are different. So no Nadi dosh. So no Nadi dosh, nakshatra is same in that situation, so Nadi dosh will not be there. So in this case nakshatra is same, so Nadi dosh is there because that is Madhya Nadi. Or what is the Nadi? Let me write here. Adi Nadi, 9 nakshatra is put into 3 Nadi, Madhya Nadi. Okay, this is, and then Antya Nadi. Antya Nadi. So how the nakshatra is put? First nakshatra, Ashwini, Here Bharani, second Madhyanadi, Kritika, two are taken together in first and third one. This is Kritika. Kritika and Rohini, they are also in the so two together. Ashni Bharani, Kritika Rohini, Mrikshara, Madhyanadi, Mrikshara, Ardra, Pundrabashu, these two will be here. Ardra, Pundrabashu, Pushya, Aslesa, Madha, Pur Fauni, Uttar Fauni, Hasta, Chitra, Swati, Vishakha, Anuradha, Anuradha Madhyanadi. So Anuradha has come in the Madhyanadi, which is Madhyanadi, and the same nadi of these two people are there. So Madhyanadi is here. Okay. Anuradha, then Jeshta, Pur Fauni, Uttar Fauni, Hasta, Chitra, Swati, Vishakha, Anuradha, Jeshta, sorry, Anuradha was here. What have done? Ashni, Bharani, Kritika, Rohini, Mrikshara, Ardra, Pundrabashu, Pushya, Aslesha, Magha, Pur Fauni, Uttar Fauni, Hasta, Chitra, Swati, Vishakha, Anuradha, Jeshta, Mula, Purvashad, Uttar Ashad, Shravan, Dhanishta, Chatrisha. In this way, Chatrisha, Pur, then Pur Bharatpad, Uttar Bharatpad, Revati. Revati in the last one. In this way, Nayana Nakshatra is put into three nadis, Adinadi, Madhyanadi. So, another Nakshatra is in between Madhyanadi. In this way, this Madhyanadi. Now, this is very important. Nadi Koot is very important. How this is important? Because with the help of this, the person's physical appearance is liked by another person or not. For example, the physique of these two people, because Nadi Dosh is not there. They are born in the two different quarters. So they are liking, I mean, Mr. Modi has constructed the statue of Sardar Patel ji. He has liked his physique. So this is physiological features. The physiological factors will be liked by them or not. If it is zero, will not be liked by them. But in this case, as I have just told you, they are born in the same nakshatra, but in different quarters. They have liked each other. I mean, if Sardar Patel ji were living here at the moment, then the two people will be like each other's physique, body. Okay, so they are, I mean, these physiological features. Sardar Patel ji's physique or body has been constructed by Modi ji. That means he has liked his physical features. So physical features or physiological features are liked by Modi ji. In this way, this Nadi Dosh is not there. As I have told you that they are born in the same nakshatra, Nadi Dosh is there, but Nadi Dosh is not considered bad in this case because they are born in the different quarters of the same nakshatra. Condition is this. If the nakshatra is same, if rasis are different, no Nadi Dosh. Third point, if the nakshatra is same but they are in different quarters, no Nadi Dosh. Third point is, if the person is born in the in different signs, okay, nakshatra is same but different signs are there, or different houses are there, different signs, matlab different houses in this case. So then Nadi Dosh is not considered bad. Okay, if again the same Rasi is there, or sorry, Nakshatra is same, but Rasi are different, if Nakshatra is different, different Nakshatra are there, Rasi are same. Sometimes Rasi is same, but Nakshatra are different. In that situation also, Nadi Dosh is not considered bad. So the three conditions are there. If Nadi is same, Nakshatra is same, but signs are different, no Nadi Dosh. Nadi Dosh is considered bad, but in that case, Nadi Dosh will not be considered bad. In this case also, nakshatra is same, but quarters are different. So no Nadi Dosh. In this case, physical features will be liked by each other. That is proved, because this live example, Mr. Modi has considered his statue. So he has liked his physical features. Physique he has liked. Okay, so now if I consider, if I will match these people's horoscope with independent India's horoscope, of 1947's horoscope, which I'll just compare, do you will like that how the physical features of these people will like or will not like? If it is zero, will not like. If it is 8 out of 8, they will like. And if I compare the independent India's horoscope with that of Pandit Nehru's horoscope and with Gandhi's horoscope, you will like that they liked that physical features of the independent India. Whether they liked or not liked, that we will discuss about later. If I take the two horoscopes of those two people, Pandit Nehru's horoscope with independent India's horoscope and Gandhi's horoscope with independent India's horoscope, I'll take them, and Jawaharlal Nehru and Gandhiji's horoscope I'll take together first, as I've taken the two these two personalities. So those two past leaders also I'll discuss about. After that, I'll take separately their horoscopes. What? Mahatma Gandhi's horoscope with that of independent India's horoscope, and Jawaharlal Nehru's horoscope with the independent India's horoscope. Similarly, Sardar Patel's horoscope with the independent India's horoscope. How, what qualities are liked by each other? Whether Sardar Patel's Baj agreed with this division of India, partition of India or not? Mr. Modi is agreed with the division of India or not? You will be surprised that they are 100% true that what kind of qualities they are having. India's qualities and Mr. Modi's quality, independent India's, whether they are liked or not liked. Mr. Modi has liked the division of country or not. Sardar Patel has liked the division of country or not. Pandit Nehru has liked the division of country or not. Mahatma Gandhi has liked the division of country or not. You will be just, you know, surprised at how they are defined clearly with the help of horoscopes of them. Okay, so horoscopes, if I compare two persons, any two persons, can it can be country, it can be a person, two living things, or one living or non-living. Okay, so in that way we have to consider. So this is a very good idea of matching the horoscope of the two people. Up to now, we, you know, people have just, you know, compared the two people's horoscope, matched the two horoscopes of the people who are going to marry. But I just suggest that no, any two people can be compared, any two people can be matched together, because they are going to run the same house, same company, same corporation, same country. If they are running, then their horoscope should be matched. Any two persons can be matched, and their ideas, their differences can be highlighted. They can be understood easily. Or if the two persons are understanding each other, their differences are known to them, then they can adjust very easily. Or they can understand that, yes, we can compromise on this point because we are not agreed. Okay, so that kind of situation can come. So agreement, disagreements are always there, but the person can be taken into confidence in that way. Okay, so they are just, you know, being suggested that these kind of differences are there, so you can take precautions so that your life can run very smoothly. So to run the life smoothly, or to run the company smoothly, to run the country smoothly, the leaders are being checked, their horoscopes are being matched, and then they can be, okay, they can think about that, what kind of qualities are there, and they should be highlighted so that person can understand that, yes, their weakness and the good points are being discussed about. And then in that way, the person can run the country in a better manner or not better manner. That is how we can discuss about. Okay, so this is how this is the last point we have discussed about. Okay, last, I mean, matching of the horoscope of these two people, these two leaders, past leader, Sardar Patelji and Mr. Modi, who is the present Prime Minister of India. And their horoscope, as I have discussed about, they are born in the same nakshatra but different quarters. Because of that, they are having similar qualities. One unified the country, and another person has also, I mean, okay, abolished that 370, Article 370, and joined the Jammu and Kashmir into India properly. So in that way, I mean, both are having similar kind of activities. And he, you know, built the Somnath temple, and he has tried to build Ram Mandir, and other things are also going on. In that way, I mean, they are liking their traditional things, cultural thinking, they are worshipping of which god? Shiva they are liking. Okay, in that way their likings are same. Similarly, if you compare Mahatma Gandhiji and Pandit Nehru's horoscope, you will be totally surprised that they are also having the same kind of activities, because they are also born in the same nakshatra. Okay, Pandit Nehru is born in the first quarter of the nakshatra, and Mahatma Gandhi is born in the fourth quarter of the same nakshatra. So that way we can discuss about. I mean, they are also, I mean, their horoscopes will also match together. I think they are also having 28 matching points, because only this one, because they are in the same nakshatra, but different quarters are there. So they are also having 36 points matching, Mahatma Gandhi and Jawaharlal Nehru. And as you have just understood, that Mahatma Gandhi was left by Jawaharlal Nehru ji since his childhood period, because after returning from UK, he went directly to his ashram, and he just, you know,